Hello, LiteSpeed Web Server admins. Today, we're going to talk about 5 reasons why you may have trouble accessing your WebAdmin console, and we'll show you how to fix each of those problems. First, we'll verify whether LiteSpeed Web Server is actually running. Then we'll talk about 403 error. We'll look into port access issues. And finally, we'll investigate reverse proxy CDN issues. Let's get started. Please note that we have added all of the commands we are using to the description below so that you can easily copy and paste them. If you can't access your WebAdmin console, the first thing you want to check is whether LiteSpeed Web Server is running. If LiteSpeed Web Server is not running, then the WebAdmin console won't be available. From your command line, run a LiteSpeed status command. If you see LiteSpeed is running, then this is not your WebAdmin problem and you can move on to the next step. If you see error, LiteSpeed is not running, try executing the start command and then try to access the WebAdmin console again. If you are getting a 403 error when you try to access your WebAdmin console, your IP address may be blocked. If you forgot to add your IP address to the access list, or if your IP address is changed, this would result in a 403 error. You'll need to add your IP address to the WebAdmin configuration file. Edit the file and add your IP to the Allow section under Security and Access Control. If you have multiple addresses, you can separate them with a comma. Save the file and restart LiteSpeed Web Server. You should now be able to access the WebAdmin console. If you're still having issues, it could be a port access issue. First, let's see if the admin port address has changed. By default, you can access the WebAdmin console at port 7080, but it's possible the port was changed for security reasons. Open the WebAdmin config file and check to see what port is in use. If the port is 7080, then this is not your WebAdmin problem, and you can move on to the next chapter. If the port is any number other than 7080, then you should be able to access your console by using the other port number. We have found that in many cases, WebAdmin access problems are due to the port being blocked by a firewall. The WebAdmin console port must be open and accessible from outside of your server. With LiteSpeed Web Server running, run the netstat command from your hosting machine to check if there is a process listening on port 7080. If there is, run the curl command to verify what the process is. If the output returns server LiteSpeed, then the LSWS WebAdmin console is working as intended within your server, but is likely being blocked by your firewall. At this point, you should check your firewall rules and either append allow rules or remove block rules as needed to provide access to the WebAdmin port. Your firewall documentation should explain how. If you've determined that LiteSpeed is listening on the correct port, and your firewall is not blocking the port, then this is not your WebAdmin problem, and you can move on to the next chapter. If you have recently enabled a reverse proxy content delivery network, like QuickCloud or Cloudflare, your example.com site is now served through a CDN. This means that the origin server is no longer accessed directly. The CDN may not know how to handle the WebAdmin console's URL and its 7080 port. You can solve the issue by creating a subdomain for your WebAdmin console, such as webadmin.example.com. This subdomain would be accessed directly and would not go through the CDN. If you have looked at all of these scenarios and you are still unable to get access to your WebAdmin console, it's possible that your hosting provider may be restricting access to the port. Contact them and ask to have the port opened for your access. Now that you've regained your access to your WebAdmin console, we suggest that you take a look at our video about keeping WebAdmin secure. We'll link it into the description, along with other resources to help with WebAdmin access. Thank you for watching, liking, sharing, and subscribing. See you soon.